Alright guys, Team 3 Star back in the Lone Piece Banners video. In today's video, we're going to be looking at Raiden Onishima Usopp. I haven't given this guy a proper re-showcase in a while, and as you know, if you're one of my, you know, usual viewers of mine, especially during streams, you guys know this was one of my favorite units in the game. This Usopp came out, and he really did have a really good spot in the meta. He came out with, obviously, the Nami during Big Mom's meta, and he really just fucked over Big Mom when she was super meta. But as a meta shift, characters like Gear 5, Filmworth Shanks, those characters are kind of just iffy on him. Gear 5 especially was not a good matchup. Shanks could be 50-50 because he can't take Hockey State that I'll talk about later. I always felt like he was always one of those units that was always just like really good, and I couldn't say why. He was just always nice, and obviously my bias aside, he's still a really, really good unit. I wouldn't say he's like the craziest anymore, but he still is a very, very good unit. But hey, this is my Usopp. He's maxed out boost 21. I'm gonna start doing his boost 4 pretty soon. I'm pretty excited for that. And also a little quick little heads up. Some of these matches are in S plus because of League reset. I was recording like insta when reset started to hit, so just keep that in mind. Obviously those are still like SS players, just in S plus because of reset, just keep that in mind. But for the metal set, I'm going to be using triple Usopp. It's going to be double Dressrosa Usopp with God Usopp metal, Savior metal, and my colored, Timeskip Usopp. Here are the tags if you are interested. It's going to be Dressrosa and then Trio Straw Hats and Trio Sharpshooter. It's not the craziest metal set, but it's kind of a wonky one that I just like to use with him. Then my point for him is he has a lot of normal attacks per fire, and that middle, the Savior metal, the God Usopp April Fool's one, will increase that normal attack, the damage output that it does. And then the other ones are also cap speed, so it does help out at the end of the day. I have cap speed on the metal set as well as both cooldowns for both skills. And talking about the skills, skill 1 is going to be Green Star Sleep Grass. It's a mid-range multiple area hit attack which has to inflict sleep. Damage dealt will change based on the enemy's max HP, so it's a fixed damage. And it also does not get affected by criticals because they cannot happen. It nullifies stagger reset period of time, and also gets an attack debuff at level 5. So it does a 15% cut to the enemy. And keep this in mind, it's a 1-2 step, so when he puts it down, it cuts you, then it sleeps you. So at times, if you are using this guy, if people can somehow dodge the sleep somehow, that can happen. So just keep that in mind. It's kind of annoying, but it is something that this skill has. Sleep is 100% obviously for 6 seconds, and attack reduced by 10% for 20 seconds on the enemy, and cooldown is 21 seconds. A very, very good skill. HP cuts are always pretty nice right now. as well as with the status behind it. And then the other one's gonna be special attack green green star exploding pine cones. It's a long range air attack with knockback effect and high critical chance, nullified by stagger for a period of time. Skill attack is 615 with knockback, and then the cooldown is 35 seconds. It's pretty short as well. I will say it does say it's long range, but I would say it's kind of like a mid to long. It kind of reminds you of God Usopp's skill one. That's kind of the range, so you can't really push it too much, but you can depending on the map. I know if you're on like Arlong, you're trying to shoot across the water, you can only hit them if they're really at the edge of the water facing you. So just keep that in mind. For the traits, obviously he has an Usopp, so he's going to be nullifying negative. He also gets two health bars back, or should I say lives, for 3% of his HP. So HP build is going to be nice to have with this guy. And then when attacking an enemy with skill 1, this is the remove hockey state. So he is the one unit that does that. And because it is a 2-step, that does work out at the end because it takes away the hockey state. And then it sleeps him, so you can actually hit Shanks with the sleep. That's actually pretty nice. And that's also good against like people like the rare Akainus nowadays. So anybody with like a status effect, you can just take it away from that way. Or it's the status that, you know, makes them stronger. When enemies are inflicted with sleep, you get a 15% heal back, and also you get skill 2 by 30%, which is pretty nice. When allies are not near the treasure, around the enemy's treasure, just when you're by yourself, you get a 50% cast speed, and also you get a damage reduction by 30%, which is really nice. You also get 50% cooldown reduction, and you guys already know I love my Usopp animations for dodges. That's something that I personally like to see to make a unit actually look good. Is if it's easier for them to dodge, or like the dodge animations, like flows really well. Characters like Kaidos always have a really weird one, so that's why I never really like those units. But just keep that in mind. Pretty good trait once again though. And then when the enemy's in the treasure area when you're capping, you also get another 50% cast speed. You also get resist dagger being down, so this helps you when you're sleeping them. You get increased cap speed as well as being able to just, you know, grab it just straight up when they're in the flag, which is really nice. And then when your HP is 50% or less, boost the cooldown reduction speed of skill 1 by 100%. So you'll get a sleep grass instantly, basically, when your HP is 50 or below. And then your boost trait for skill for boost 2. Like I said, he is a unit that can cap when people are in the flag. But his restriction is they need to be slept. He's kind of like Green Bull in that matter. Green Bull has a HP threshold, so keep that in mind. It's still a very, very good trait, though. On the side, I'm using Claw because Claw is still phenomenal. And I don't think they have that much love anymore, so I might make a showcase on them later. Let me know if you are interested in that. But there's the build if you are interested. Defensive build for them, of course. And then the percentage is going to be 170.2. It's going to be an attack setup, actually. So Attacker, Shot, Pirates, New World, Worst Gen, Paramecia, Captain, Defender, Runner, and Grand Line. I was going to use a defensive build with this guy, but since he's already so defensive with his reduction, I wanted to push his damage out just a little bit because my attack stat on him isn't too high. And with skill 2 being a high chance to crit, it'll help him in the long run. And then also having worst gen for the knockback is actually pretty nice. But yeah, this is my Usopp. Like I said, he's not the worst right now. He's still pretty fucking good. You just really have to pick and choose your battles. I wouldn't say he's like the greatest, because it never really was. But he's always a good side unit for you to play. So yeah, let me know what you guys think about this Usopp in today's meta. Like I said, it's been a while since I played this guy, and I wanted to give him a revisit since I did play almost every single Usopp now at this point in the channel. So yeah, let me know what you guys think about Raiden Onigashima Usopp in the comments down below. Do you think he's as good as I think he is? Like I said, you can definitely rock a different build and set up entirely. Attack HP is fine. Attack defense is fine. You could really just rock whatever, but yeah, let me know what you guys think about this Usopp. Let me know if you guys play him. Let me know how I did, as well as what you think about the games. Of course, I always love to read you guys' comments. And with that being said, this Team 3 Stars signing out, and I'll see you guys next video. Peace.
倒せねえから王冠だよ。僕だって海へ。 Good.